This is the Auckland International Airport, getting ready for our flight. There's Brian, he's in the band too.
I saw all your family over there.
They were from Fiji.
Oh, Fiji. Yeah, no, we're not going to Fiji, we're going to Norfolk Island. And we're going to have a good time.
And what sort of things are we going to experience over Norfolk Island?
Well, there's lots of things for us to see in Norfolk Island. We've got, it's actually full of all sorts of things. You know, the fishing. I think if you like fishing, this is the place to go. The last time I was in fishing, I caught seven at once. Seven? Tahirua Toru fast. Seven?
Mermaids.
We're just waiting for the plane to get in. Then we can go and check our bags in. As you can see, we've got quite a load here.
Okay, time's up now, Dennis. Thank you.
we're on flight YE3983. And we've got about 20 minutes and we'll be landing in Norfolk Island.
No, I'm allowed, I ask.
Everything is going to plan so far, and just looking out our window, we're pretty high up here, aren't we?
Aren't we, Dennis?
We're flying about 25,000 feet.
How do you know?
At the moment, oh, special detection on my body.
Well, so far, so good, we've made it. And now we're just organising of where we're going to be staying. So here we are, Norfolk Island.
One thing with Norfolk Island, Dion?
Yes.
No ding 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 ding. Ding ding ding.
Casino.
Yeah, no casino. Some people wanted them on the island. So they had a boatload of them come in from Australia, I think it was. And they lost them. They lost all the machines that they were bringing here.
Mm.
They accidentally fell over the side.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, the guys that were against bringing them in just dropped them over in the sea and never to be seen again. So they're out there in the sea somewhere, the fish playing pokey-shaki.
That's a hokey-pokey.
Oh, hokey-pokey.
Right, as you can see behind me, that this is the main street of the town, right here at Norfolk. And later on, we're going to be setting up our gear in this place, which is right over here, and that's the Memorial Club, otherwise known as the RSL. It's just like our RSA back there in Kai Tai. Well, should I say in Kai Tai?
Goodness, eh?
Beautiful amps. How you got these good amps?
Get a job.
Yeah. When do you get the taxing from which?
Honourable Grant Tambling.
Is that right?
All right.
Dennis, nice to be with you.
Yeah, and thank you very much for putting on the weather for us.
Well, I don't know that I have too much say over that. I think if we can generally take our line, but if New Zealand is fine, we're a bit better.
Oh, I think
but
you
if
are.
Right. If Australia is wet and windy, then 2 or 3 days later, we probably are wet and windy. But it's lovely that you're here on such a good occasion.
Oh, good. Now, a couple of questions. How did you come by coming to Norfolk?
Well, I first came to Norfolk in 1991. I was a senator in the Australian Federal Parliament.
Oh, yes.
And at that time, I was the shadow minister in opposition, which nobody likes to be.
All right.
But I was in opposition in the Australian Parliament. I came out here in 91 and I rang my wife and said, would you believe I found paradise? And she said, well, you're never going again without me. So the following year, in 1992, we came out again and thoroughly loved it. My political career went on, coasted through all sorts of things until I quit politics in 2001, did a few other things for a year or two, and then I got a tap on the shoulder and I was asked by my colleagues in Canberra, would I like to look at the job of administrator of Norfolk Island? And I said, that is paradise. I'm sure I'd love to go back there.
Oh, sure.
And we've just been here 12 months now. We're thoroughly enjoying it. It's not a hard post. And it's very enjoyable socially, but surprisingly, there's always something happening.
A ko nei ra te wā hia kia nei, te whanga o Anson, Anson Bay. Ai ai ki tā mātou kai arahi, kai kōrero. Ko nei te wā hi, haere mai ei te nuingo ngā Māori, a ki te tiki o rātou kina. Ngā kai mātaitei, kai moana hoki. Ngā kino kunei, anāke te nui. Nā kei te nui. Ngāri he roroa hoki ngā ona waiwai o ngā kine o konei. Ngāri āhua māta tauru ana, taumahana ki te huakine i te kōhā. Ngāri, maui ana tēnei wāhi e te kina. Te rāpō i kai mātau i ngā kine o konei, e tama, e rua pē ngā kine kua ki te tangata. Ngāri, e koenei te wāhi e kia nei Anson Bay, koenei hoki te wāhi e whānau ai ngā mangao. Ne kia nei etahi o tātou ngā pioke o tēnei takiwā. E whāngai a e whānau ai o rātou pēpi. Ai, koe nira te wāhi. Hei te ātāhu o tā mātou haere. Koe nira ko tai mai mātou ki te tēnei wāhi. Te whare e tirohia nei a mātou, koe nei te wāhi nōhia. E ngā tō reka reka i mai mau mai hira i poi hākena, i noho nei rātou i konei. Koe nei tō rātou kāinga. Tiarisi koe, mahi kē ki te kōhatu, i te raima hoki. Koe nei te ahota mō tā rātou noho. Ankai muri ake nei nā, e ai ki tā mātou kōrero atā mātou kai arahi. Nā rātou whare paku kai muri nei nā. Nā i jiji noi ho, kotahi noi hupa te rīma, te rūma kai konei, i noho i rātou. Te mai koutou karanau hei whānui. Ko te ahi, te wāhi noho, te wāhi moenga. Ko e nei hura tēnei whare. I nā e nei nā ko whakarapa hia mai he rino ki runga i ngā pātū o tēnei whare, engari te nuinga, ngā rima, raima, e ngā kōhatu no tēnei takiwa.
Our hosts have been here for a long time. They have big history in Norfolk Island, so they might like to share a little bit of it with us. So we'll turn to Norman, and I was fascinated because nearly everywhere we've been we've had coconut pie, and you just can't find any coconut anywhere on Norfolk Island, and yet it's one of their main dishes. Now how come you have coconut pie so
everything
much.
Everything else except coconut.
We got everything else?
See, coconut.
Oh, do you have pineapple here as well?
Yes.
Growing?
Yes. Yes.
All right. So how come coconuts become part of the diet?
Well,
the olden days.
We buy it from the shop.
the olden days, like they must have brought it here like from Pitcairn and that. When they come across more than likely.
Yeah.
And then the traders coming in, they bring the coconut.
But there's nothing growing.
No.
No coconut.
Oh, you got everything Tahiti got, but you only know got no coconut.
That's right.
The sum's right.
Yeah. And so, as far as you can remember, how far back in the history of Norfolk Island can you take us?
Not far.
Just down to the boat.
She's been away, what? We got married in 51.
Yes.
Well, she's been away since then from Norfolk.
Yes.
And she was away, what, 12 months? No.
I went over to Australia when my father joined the army. And that's where I stayed until I got married.
Yes.
And we built a home in Kingsgrove.
All
right. And then when Norman retired, we came back where we left.
This is your roots?
Yeah. I was born on this property here.
Oh, right.
And my mother was...
Near that tree, just up the back, up here, that big
oak
tree?
Not this house. Yeah. There was an old house on this property.
Oh,
but,
right.
You know, it was taken down, you know, like...
Removed.
It was removed. And when we came back to live, we built this one.
I'm Eve Semple and I'm the director of the Norfolk Highland Museum. We're standing outside the commissariat store, which was built in 1835 during the second penal settlement by Major John Anderson. Downstairs in the basement of this store is the commissariat museum, and in this museum are two beautiful patu which were given by the Maoris on the return of Huru and Tuki. Philip Gidley King essentially kidnapped these two Maoris to come to Norfolk Island to teach them how to weave flax. When the Maoris came to Norfolk Island, King quickly discovered that he had kidnapped the wrong gender and that flax weaving was for females only. King returned Tuhi and Huru to New Zealand, and the tribe, to give thanks, gave the patu to the King. King's family retained the patu until the 1900s. They gave it to the Mitchell Library, who in turn gave it then to the Australian Museum, who in turn gave it to the Maori community in Sydney, who then gave it to Norfolk Island. So those patu made its full circle 200 years later.
There's the old wharf where they pull the boats in and out of the water. And if it's too rough on this side of the island, they'd go across to Kingston, where we've got a few photos of them already taking up boats out of the water. And when a ship does come in, they park it out towards sea there. Then they run these little boats in. They call them lighters. And these guys can unload a boat quicker than the machinery that we have in New Zealand down at the Auckland Wharf. They can load a boat quicker than they can, and they do it all by hand right here on this wharf, or the one down at Kingston. And along a bit further from the wharf is the remains of a whale station, a whale boiling pot up there where they used to drag the whales up through here and up onto the platform, where you can see the remains of the boiler. And so this was quite a unique sort of an area where a lot of the islands used to come and work and cut up the whales and take the whale blubber and the whale oil, etc., from here. So I think we've seen quite a lot of the island now, and we'll get back to you as soon as we come together very soon. Nō reira, kia ora.
When the islanders built the mission workers built the chapel back in 1860, they used materials from the convict jail. All the sandstone blocks and most of the walls came from the convict jails from down at Kingston. So already got history in a chapel straight away. Back in the old days, the roofing was actually made out of Norfolk pine shingles for the roofing. Nowadays it's like an asbestos type material, but not asbestos. And the timber work is all Norfolk pine. I'll touch a lot about the mission once we go inside. So, this is a Melanesian mission chapel built in 1860 by the Melanesian mission. Now, prior to 1860, the Melanesian mission was actually located in Auckland in New Zealand. The rafters and the roof are all made out of Norfolk pine. Now, we had no treatment plant back in the early days here on Norfolk Island, so we're using a method that we learned from the convicts to treat our timber. We don't have termites on Norfolk, but we do have the bug called Bora Bora, which is like a cricket. It's the closest I can describe it to for you. Now, what they did, they knocked down a big Norfolk pine tree, drag it down to Emily and Slaughter Bay, our two safest swimming areas, wrap heavy chains around their logs and submerge in the salt water for up to 2 years to let the salt water penetrate the timber. After 2 years, they drag the logs up, let it air for about 6 months, and cut it into the length of timber that they want. And then they coat it with whale oil. That's how they preserve the timber. That's how all this timber work was treated.
Tira mai koutou te wāhi tatatone nei ki au, koinei te wāhi takotohia e ngā tūpāpaka. Ka mate ana te tahi, kua mauhia mai koinei takotoai. Anā i kona tatatu, o te wāhi i pokahia i ngā tinana o ngā tūpāpaka. Kia mōhio ai ngā tākuta, he aha, te taka i mate ai, i tūpāpaka. Nā te tahi wāhi anō kai te tatatu, koinei te wāhi tahui ai o rātau kai. Koe te kihini, i tahu hi ai wā rātau kai. Nā tēnei taki wā katoa ko te hōhipera, ko te hōhipera o tēnei wāhi, e ki nei te Penal Institution. Te mai koutou i ngā tepa, i takahia nei e ngā rawa kore o tango taki wā. Pākaru karu katoa o Wainganui, hea hai, nā ngā rino e maunei ki o rātau waiwai. Ka heke ana ki raro ngā tepa nei, ana ka takawiri ngā rinora, ngā ball, iron balls, nā ka wāwāhi a ngā tepa nei. Haunga no ngā kai o te ture, haere kai mā te taha nei, nā tikin titiro mai koutou, kei te paitonu te takoto a ngā rākau, a ngā kuhatio konei. Engari tēnei nā ngā rawa kore, rā rātau i wā wāhi, a hoki eka ana ki raro. Anā hoki tō rātau whare e kia nei te exercise yard me etahi atu o ngā wāhi i noho hia i rātau. Paki te koutou. Anā hei ai ki ngā kōrata mātau kai arahi. Kāre herawa ngā iwi o tēnei takiwā me ngā Pitcairn Islanders i tautoko. Ki ngā mahi, i mahia e te ture i tēnei takiwā o rātau. Nā reira, nā rātau i papahoro, haka papahoro, ngā whare nei. Kāre rātau i tautoko i ngā mahi, mahi kino i mahi hia ki te tangata e te ture i tēnei takiwā. Nā reira, ki te mai koutou, ko waho anake, ko te kiri anake, ko te pātū anake e tū ana. Nā whare kato i roto nei nā, ko ngaro ngaro kato. Nā i hara nā te ture i papahoro, nā ngā pirke nā alandeske. Ngā iwi o tēnei mautere. E titurana nei māua ki ngā whare paku o tēnei wāhi. Nā noho ai rātai kunana, ka mahi o rātau mahi. Ka pari mai te tai ki kato i te wai, nā. Ko heke te tai, ko timo te tai, anā ko horo i atu, anā ki te wāi, ki tātahi. Pai haere tonu atu. Mā te hinangaro noi e whakaaro, e ahai, e ahi pēnei rā wāi, te tiaki a te tangata. Ngā whare heri ro nai nei, e hō tērā katoi nai nei. Ngari ti tioti ki tēnei, o tō takiwa, o tō wā, a hua weti weti ana, a hua weti weti ana.
Ah, kia ora, kia ora, and we're here at Norfolk Island Radio, and I just finished being on air with George. In fact, I had a bit of a turn here as well. As you can see, that the radio station is fairly big, bigger than ours back home there at Tehiku, 94.4 FM, but hey, it does the same job. And they've also got CD players, and not quite automated as yet, but anyway, oh look, there's a Maori in the car. That is an unusual sight to see someone like that.
He te rangatiro o tēnei reo irirangi. He hara mai te kōrero i ngā huatanga e pānekia ngai tau. I tēnei haere ngā tātou. He whai haere nei tō tātou rangatira i a Dennis Marsh. He kore ngaro, he kore musu tātou mihi ki a rātou. Tā rātou manaaki. Manaaki, tino manaaki i a tātou e noho neina. O hoki atu tātou ki te wā kāinga, ko ki ki katoa tātou puku. Kare tātou e noho noi ho, e noho noi ho, he kaitonu te tumahi. Nō reka tino miha te rakia o tātou, kai arahi i konei. Me o tātou wāhine no hoki no te kāinga. Kai konei e mahi mahi ana ia Unisma. Me e tahi ono o Aotearo o taitai mai ki te Harare. Me nā koutou hi hiana, koe nei te wāhi e haere mai ki te, me haere mai ki te Harare. Te rau e o te wāhi nei. He rite tonu ki te kai. Engari te mea rere ke ke. Ko ngā rākau e tūtū nei ngā Norfolk Pine. Ko ina nohu te wāhi re re ke. Engari he rau e, he rau e. Nore haere mai. Tia kina a koutou moni. Ke tai e tūtū mai a koutou hurahi ki konei. Hei Harare.
Kia ora, Uncle Ben. We're going to be talking now with George Smith, and what's your position here at Norfolk Island Radio, George?
Dion, I'm the broadcast manager for Radio Norfolk and the television services.
And how long have you been in that position?
12 months.
Oh, just fresh.
Just fresh, but I started working in radio here on Radio Norfolk a fair way back, about 1976.
So it's been going for quite a while now?
Yeah, Radio Norfolk's been going since the early 50s. And it used to be on air for about 5 minutes. I used to only put it on when there was an aeroplane due. And that was it used to be once a fortnight, or if the ship came in, they'd put it on for that as well. So it's changed now, it's on 24 hours a day. And we do live broadcasts Monday to Friday from 6:30 through to 9 or 10 o'clock at night. On the weekends, we only go from 6:30 to 4 o'clock.
Now, with Norfolk Island Radio, is it government-funded in any way, or how do you get your income?
Yes, it is. Radio Norfolk is part of the administration here, which means it's part of the government. But in addition to that, we run a sponsorship program here, and run little, they're not commercials, but just, you know, time calls and things like that, which gives the station a little bit of extra money to buy CDs and things like that.
Now, with that, you get many visitors coming in to have a look around at the radio station?
Sometimes we do. We had a lot this morning.
But, you were invaded by Māori, you know.
We were, and it was our pleasure. It was really good. But otherwise, not a lot. We've got the library right next door, so people will come to the library and sort of come around the back and say, what's this? This is the radio.
How important is the radio to Norfolk Island?
I think it's very important for communications. Generally, you know, the average day we just play music and give news of local events and things. But it can be very important for really bad situations like cyclones and things like that, too, so people can know what's going on, if the power's off in their area and things like that. But it, I believe it's an important function there.
And will Radio Norfolk or Norfolk Radio, what is it called?
It's Radio Norfolk.
Okay. Is it going to be here for the next 50,000 years?
I think so, but I don't think they're going to keep me here that long.
You could be called Jurassic Radio Norfolk.
Dion, they're calling it that now with me when I get in there on the mic.
But thank you, George. It's been really good, and thank you for the experience here.
Dion, it's been a real pleasure for me for the radio, but it's also great to have you guys here from New Zealand doing the entertainment that's been going on over the last week. It's been well received, and the shows haven't finished yet, so look forward to seeing what's left.
Maori John's Polynesian Licensed Restaurant. We want to find out a little bit about this Maori business. I'm not quite sure whether he's real Maori or half island. But we're going to have a chat with this man very, very soon. And he's the proprietor of this establishment. And we're going to get him to tell us a little bit about how and why and how he's getting on here on Norfolk Island as a New Zealand Maori. How about that? Won't be long, he'll be coming up the aisle there and sitting with us and sharing his experiences of life.
Kia ora, John.
And this is John. Now, sit down, take a seat, John. Let's have a bit of a yarn. First of all, this is John. We're going to ask him whereabouts in New Zealand he's from. Kia ora.
Oh, kia ora. I'm from the Hokianga.
Hokianga?
Aye.
And how long ago since you left the Hokianga?
Oh, well, I left there in 1996.
96?
Yep, went to Perth.
Perth?
Mm.
And from Perth?
From Perth, then I went to Sydney, and from there, from Sydney, I went to the Gold Coast.
Was it easy for you to find work, or what sort of mahi were you involved with?
Well, back in Perth, I took up a lot of things, yeah. You know, as we do, entrepreneurs. But mainly a lot of singing.
Singing or, yeah. Or entertaining?
Entertaining, yeah.
Yeah, entertaining. Yeah, man. And you got to the Gold Coast, of course, and you spend a lot of your time there entertaining?
Yeah, a lot of time entertaining on the Gold Coast, yeah.
Any names that we might sort of recognise?
No.
No.
I suppose because I was with the mainly doing the R&B scene, you know, like with Sex and Chocolate and in a band called Cherbro. But there's an old fellow there that does a lot of live stuff too, and his name is Tui Tamuti.
Tui Tamuti.
Aye.
Tui Tamuti.
Aye.
All right. What group was he involved with?
Well, he's got his own band, and they do real well on the coast. Yeah. And he's mainly over at Sylvester's on the Gold Coast.
All right.
So if you get a chance to see him, that's a place.
Place to go.
That's a place, yeah.
Now, what brought you here to Norfolk Island? It's a bit of land, a little bit of land not much bigger than Waiheke, man, and right out in the middle of the sea. What brought you here?
Well, what really brought me here was because the RSL, which would have been the RSAs at home,
oh, yes.
Which is the same thing, asked me and two others to come over here and sing, and we came here about three or four times to sing. And because I like the place, and mainly because of the protocol of the place, remind me of, you know, of home in the early 70s. And that's the way it is more or less here. And that's why I love the place, and that's why I stayed. I lease the restaurant.
Right.
I don't own it. And, it's going real well at the moment. And having people like yourself and also your band members, it's even just as good and just as good. And we've had a lot of entertainers, Māori entertainers that have come in here.
Yes.
And they feel at home because, you know.
It is home.
That's it.
It is home.
That's it.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah. But you have a hangi now. How do you do that? You need a bigger hole at the back?
No, well, these days they've got those things at home called kai cookers.
All right, yeah, we have two men. Don't have to get dirty.
That's right. And it's the closest thing, I tell you.
All right. And you have one of those every day, or?
No, we have it usually two nights a week.
All right.
On a Thursday where we have a Polynesian night.
Yeah.
And then we have the Sunday night which you have a Polynesian night as well.
All right, so people get a bit of a variety.
They
when
do.
They come to Mary John's Polynesian restaurant.
Yeah, they do actually, but it's even more variety when people, like I say, like yourself and your band and other entertainers come here.
Yeah, but we sort of haven't had a lot of time to come in and visit you as much as we would like, but I'm sure next time you probably will get rid of us.
You bet, yeah. You're more than welcome, and anyone else that are out there that are coming to Norfolk Island, if you want to... A real Māori atmosphere, this is the place to
come here.
Well, Dennis, as you can see, this is a brand new boat, and it's taken a couple of years to build, all voluntary work, about eight of us on and off, two nights a week for a couple of hours each night, and it's a replica of the old Bedford whaling boat, used by the Americans in the 1840s right through to 1880.
1840s.
And it's turned out quite good. We've never tackled this sort of project before.
No.
And we learnt a lot of things as we went. Normally they used to steam all the planks and the ribs and everything.
Yes.
We managed to do that without that.
Is that right?
And it's all copper nailed and robed.
Yes.
We've used a bit of glue. West system glue.
Yes.
So Yeah, this is how it is, and it's 31 foot long in all imperial measurements.
Yes, yep.
And as you can see, it has five oars and one steerage oar, which is the long one there.
All right.
And it slots at the back. It also has a tiller, and it's also powered by a sail.
All right, yep.
It has a centerboard that drops down.
Yep.
That's a bamboo mast that we were thinking of using over there.
Oh, yes, hanging there, yeah.
Yeah, we had to straighten it a little bit.
Oh, okay.
This is the bow.
All right.
And that's the loggerhead, what they call the loggerhead at the back where the rope is curled around.
Yep.
And that up there is the guy that steers it. He controls the rope.
Oh, right.
He plays the rope.
Yes.
Like when you're fishing, you know.
Yeah.
But on a larger scale, of course.
Yes.
And when the rope goes slack, it'll lay along the seat and they haul up on the rope. And if the whale takes off again,
they let it go.
Then he has to play that rope so it goes in and out, you know.
Yes, yes.
With the weight of the whale.
I mean, this guy is trying to hold something like 3 or 4 tons, wouldn't he?
Or 50.
50 tons? So with three
around the loggerhead,
yes,
it's easy.
Yeah.
Two is not enough. Four is too much.
All right.
So it has to be able to be flexible to move without any trouble.
All right.
And they all up in the bow there. There's a little section there where they always carried a little hatchet. And everybody carried a knife in case they had to chop that rope in a hurry.
All right.
And of course, it was the guy that harpooned it. He came from the back because the fellas sitting there, they were steadying the boat.
Yeah.
Coming up to the whale, and he would come up, pick up the harpoon. They carried about four harpoons in here.
Yeah.
And the line was coiled in a tub, like a keg, you know, like a cut-down keg.
Yes, yes.
It was coiled in the back there, and it had to be coiled in such a manner
that it would unroll.
So as it would peel out without fouling.
Yep.
And he would come up, throw the harpoon, and then return back to that station up there.
And keep a tension on the rope.
Keep the tension on the rope. We had a team here that used to operate the whaling in Ball Bay, and they got a chaser across from Picton in New Zealand.
All right.
They shipped it up, and they were having problems catching whales. And a group of these old fellas, they still had one of these boats operating. And he said, "Now look, we'll show you how to do it the old way, but the deal is you've got to bring your new boat out and tow it in."
All right.
Right, so what happened was they set out early in the morning, and they were sitting near Phillip Island because they hadn't seen any whales.
Yeah.
And everybody knew this was happening. So what happened was we spotted a whale. And because they were only a couple of miles off, you see, and they could see us on the shoreline, signaled them frantically.
Yeah.
Right, they put the sail up. And they sailed right across, and we were looking down on them because we're, you know, 300 foot high cliff there. And lo and behold, they sailed right over on the top of this whale, harpooned it, and as soon as that happened, down come the sail and they were off. And we were able to see the whale chaser that was moored in Emily Bay.
Yes.
We see it come out through the gap in the reef. Now this boat had been towed across on the east end of Phillip, out in that direction.
Right.
We see him come out, and he goes across to the west. We never seen him again.
The boat?
No. Anyhow, the story goes, they did kill the whale.
Yes.
But they couldn't bring it back.
Oh, right.
Because, you know, it was this
too
sort
heavy.
Of...
heavy. Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
So they cut loose, and a storm came up about 2 weeks later after this event, and the whale remains washed up into Slaughter Bay.
Is that right?
And the tail section from, you know, from a, from halfway up,
yep,
is still buried there today.
Oh, it's Slaughter Bay.
In Slaughter Bay.
All right.
And I was lucky enough to witness that event with one of these old
whalers.
Whalers.
So thank you, Wiggy, once again for giving us this pleasure of coming in to view your work. And we know that not a lot of people here on Norfolk have seen it. So thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Tēnā rā koutou e teiwi. Ki mātakitaki mai nei. Koenei mātou te ropu o te pēne a Dennis Marsh. E takahi nei tēnei mautere o Norfolk Island. Nā te atāhu o tēnei wāhi a mātou e haere nei. E hakarongo nei ki ngā whakamārama a tā mātou karai arahi. Nā kei te haere tonu mātou ki te nui ngō te motu nei. Rā no ngā wāhi I tau mai ai ngā te whare herere, I mahi ai nei te whare herere mō rātou I mahi kino nei mai I Poihākana. Nā I tau mai nei ki konei. I roto I ngā kōrero a te kai rangatira neina, hei wia no I muatu I a rātou I konei. No Tahiti e tahi, I konei na e no hoana. Anā nā rātou I mai mai ngā kai ātāhua kato I konei. Anā te tainga mai o te waka neina, the mutiny o te bounty, ne? A koe nei te ngā kōrero. Anā ka heke mai ai etahi o rā hekatu ai atau etahi o rātau ki Pitcairn Island. Anā te kaiarahi o mātau I tēnei rā, he uri tēnei mai rā no o tau āhuatanga I mahi kino hiera I tau waka I tau wā. Nō rei koe nei ngā whakamārama o tēnei wā e te iwi, ka hoki mai anō kau e huri atu, ka hoki mai anō mātou. Anei anō rā mātou e tūnei I tēnei wāhi, e titiratu nei ki te moana whānui, te moana nui ākiwa. Koini anō te wāhi tahi wāhi I te unga mai o Kāpene Kuki. Ka titiratu ki te moana ki ngā kōhatu e ngā toka, kei konei tonu, te āho nei ki kīana I te kina. Koini hoki te kōrera mai a te tamātou rangatira, ki kīana I te kina I te pāua, kāre hoki tāngata e kai ani tēnā tū kai o tātau I tunu. Anā, ngā ika hoki, ngā momo ika katoa kai konei, ngā hāpuka, ko hōhā noi o rātau I te kai hāpuka. Engari kai te tatari mātau, āhea mātau ka kai hāpuka ai. Nō reira, koe nei tēnei wāhi ātāhua I koro nei mātau ki ngā pāhea I heke aka neina, e rere kia anō o rātau hakaaro ki tēnei takiwā. Koe nō mātau, te ātāhua o tēnei wāhi. I te tonu ki ngā taha moana, ngā akau o Ngāti Prau, tai atu ki te taitokera. Koe nei rā.
They shall grow not old as we that are left grow old. Age shall not weary them, nor the years condemn. At the going down of the sun and in the morning, we will remember them.
A tēnā rā koutou e mahatake te ke mai nei te wā kāinga. Nā i roto hoki o te taitokera u ngā puhi. Anei mātou te rōpū a Dennis Marsh kei roto I te whare taonga, te whare maumaharatonga o ngā hoia I hingātu I ngā pakanga o mua. Kei konei mātou e whakangahua nei tēnei wāhi, tēnei mautere o Norfolk. Anā, koe nei te pō tuatoru o tā mātou haere mai, te whakangahua I ngā iwi o konei. He nui tonu hoki ngā iwi o te mautere o Aotearoa. E haere mai ni kunei ki te hararei, ana rikarika ana mātou, ko noho noho mātou, kai kōrero wanga I a mātou, a nō hea koe, nō tēnā takiwā, nō tērā takiwā. Nō rei e tino haka miharo ana mātou I ngā iwi katoa mō Aotearoa e haere mai ni kunei. Koe ni te kāinga e manaaki nei I a mātou I tēnei wā, I nanahi, koeira te rā, maumaharatanga mō ngā hoia, I hinga I ngā pakanga o mua. Nō rei e... E aroha no hoki, ka hoki no hoki ngā māharaki o tātou I ngā roatu, nai ngā pakanga tuatahi, tūrua hoki o te ao. No reira koe nei mātou I koe nane mihi atu no ki te tākoutou mōkai ki a Dion, koe e tēnei e whakahai nei tēnei whakahuatanga o tēnei mahi a mātou I koe. No reira, tēnā koutou, noho mai. Thank you.
Today is our last day. We're just waiting for our jet to arrive. We're flying Norfolk jet. And very sad to see this place as we depart. It's time for us to leave now. Our plane has just landed, and we'll be on our way out through the departure lounge in about 5 or 10 minutes' time. We thoroughly enjoyed ourselves, and so have the guys. Oh, look, they're ready to do a waiata. Not. I think they had enough waiata. And also, we'd like to introduce to you a guy that sort of got us over here, and that's Kerry. Thank you very much, Kerry.
Thank you. Thank you very much for coming.
And we thoroughly enjoyed the hospitality of your people over here in Norfolk.
Thank you, and I'm glad you left some kindness behind for the next lot that come over, or for next time when you come over.
And maybe when you come over to New Zealand, we, of course, will be happy to repay what you fellas have given us.
Thank you very much. Thanks.
Thank you.
Tēnā rā koutou e te iwi. Whahura tēnei Ben Tāwhiti. E mihi atu nei mai I te taunga rererangi o te mautere o Norfolk, Norfolk Island. Ko ni te rā whakamutunga o tā mātau noho I konei, ko tahi wiki I konei, e awhi nei I a Dennis Marsh. Ko mātau katoa te pēne o tāna roapu I harama nei te ngahau. Whakangahau I tēnei mautere, ngā iwi o tēnei mautere. E mei te tono hoki ki ngā iwi o tātou, te iwi Māori kei konei e noho noho an. He nui tonu hoki. Ana o tira kato o Aotearoa ka tai tai mai, haere mai nei ki te harare. E kore ngaro wa aku nei mihi ki tēnei mautere, ngā iwi o tēnei mautere e kia nei, ngā uri o te mutiny o the bounty. Kei konei katoa, aroha te kena ki a rātau e noho nei tēnei takiwā. Koinei katoa hoki, ngā kōrero kei roto I tēnei mautere, ka ki te koutou I rungu te pauka whakāta, I pikitia hia nei e tā koutou mokapuna, a Dion, e pāna I tēnei takiwā. Nō reira, koinei mātau e mihi atu nei, koinei te rā whakamutunga mātau, nā kei muri nei ko tō mātau waka, e hoki atu anu nei. Nā ki o Aotera o mai I tēnei mautere o Norfolk Island. Nō rei ki a koutou katoa I mātake I teke mai nei, tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou katoa.
Flying home to you.
looked up above for the wings of the silver bird.
Yes, I'm proud. I'm proud to be